in this video revealing the 7 ways to build wealth in your 20s so that you could get rich in your 30s and 40s and 50s and never have to work ever again for the rest of your life. More of that after the intro. Hey guys, how's it going? Mike Vasile here. Welcome to this video. Before we actually begin, I remind you that several spots have opened up for this week's free workshop where it's the fastest and easiest way to make money online. Sign up for it in the link below. We literally have a 62-year-old woman go from zero to 160 grand profit in 90 days, so sign up for it now. So one of my most earliest memories when I was younger is literally seeing my mom and my dad work like 8 to 12 to sometimes even 16 hours a day to just make ends meet. And they were always stressed, they were always fighting about money, and it was just like a weird environment to grow up with, and I just had this really weird relationship with money. But I knew one thing was for sure. When I was older, I did not want to be in the same situation as my parents, and I didn't want to let money control my life and be a slave to money, which is why I literally did everything that I could possibly do to build wealth in my 20s, right? Because I didn't want to wait until I was older to enjoy my life. I wanted to do it, you know, while I was young, while I had the energy, and while I had the time to enjoy it. And even though a lot of things were very, very difficult and challenging, and there was so many times I wanted to give up when, you know, I first got started, we literally got to the point where some of it started doing really well. Like one business went from zero to $8,000 in 30 days. Another business went from zero to $5,000 in 30 days to $1.6 million in sales that first 12 months. To another business, which is my favorite business, my digital real estate business, pulls in anywhere from $35,000 to $46,000 a month. And I started learning ways to, for example, build wealth and investing it. But if I was gonna start this all over again and I could go in a time machine and go back in time to, you know, my 13-year-old self or my 19-year-old self that's about to turn 20, I wish I would have told this person these 7 things that I'm gonna tell you right now, because I feel like I would have achieved it a lot sooner and would not have made as many painful mistakes. And the first step is actually understanding to not keep up with the Joneses. Now, what do I mean by that? There's this natural phenomenon that just happens in humans where it's greed and envy, right? Those are some of the most painful emotions ever. If you feel greed or envy or jealousy, that will literally destroy you, right? And it's those literally emotions, those sinful sins that people feel, that actually cause people to like prolong wealth, right? Why? Because, oh, they're like, oh, Becky has this, you know, car, I need to get that car. Or, you know, Jackson has that, you know, nice apartment, I need to get a nicer apartment. And you're always comparing people's outsides to your insides, and you always feel like inadequate. So you want to keep up with the Joneses, because most people get a sense of self-worth based off of the perception of how other people see them as, based off of the things that they own. So the first step that I would have understood to literally build wealth faster is to don't fall in the trap of keeping up with the Joneses and to buy things just because other people are buying it. You know, I literally almost fell into this trap, right? Like a lot of my friends were getting like nice cars and apartments, and you know, I was living at home with my parents. Even when, you know, we went to like this year right here, right? Zero to $1.6 million in sales that first year. Even when we started scaling like crazy, I was still living at home with my parents. And you know, that was like so hard. That was so hard because people were like, Mike, I thought you had a business. Why are you still living it up with your parents? And I wanted to prove to them that I was successful. I wanted to buy a nice car. I wanted to buy nice things. But like I said, I knew that this first level of pain, which is keeping up with the Joneses, will prevent me from, for example, building real wealth. Had I, for example, gotten a house and a mortgage, like what a lot of my friends were doing, I wouldn't have gotten to the point where I'm at like today, right? But it's very hard to go against the grain and to not keep up with the Joneses for like a year or two while everyone seems like they look more successful than you, for you to literally almost like, you know, just, you know, kind of struggle as you're saving money for your future. Does that make sense? The second thing that I wish I knew earlier was to track my expenses, right? So I literally had a friend back in the day where we wanted to get into business, right? And we each needed to put $500 into, for example, this business account so we could start this business idea. But when I told him we both needed to put $500 so that we could be like equal partners, he's like, Mike, I don't have $500. I'm like, dude, you get paid $3,000 a month. You have a good job. You live at home with your parents. Where's all that money going? So what he started doing was he tracked his expenses, and he started realizing that over $1,000 a month literally goes to Chipotle. A lot of money goes to the bars and the clubs, and we started realizing when he started tracking it that he did not know that he was constantly spending that money, right? And that's what most people face.
You know, what gets measured gets managed. But if you don't know how much you're actually spending, you will never actually know how you can actually start saving money. And the moment he started getting really like precise on what he was spending on, naturally started spending less on it. That's literally what we do here. Like, I literally live here in Bali, Indonesia, and it's really cool because you have a lot of these people that, for example, have similar values as me. They want to make as much money as possible for their future, like this 11-year-old girl that turned on $30 million, or this guy that makes $1 million per month that I interview on my podcast, but they also want to keep their expenses as low as possible because they don't want to be a slave to the things that they purchase, right? So for me, how we track our expenses still, even though we make good money, more so than above average than like the typical like American, I still give myself like a budget of like, you know, $2,000 a month, where we literally put it like in cash, right? And it's red because it's like in Indonesia rupiah. And we literally like keep everything in cash and we only spend cash here so that we can literally track our expenses. And when we started managing it, I literally started spending less and 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 less, to the point where now, you know, we spend very little on how much money I actually make, but it's fine because then I could actually, like, for example, invest in the difference. I remember I got it to the point where I was spending very, very little, where I literally moved to Thailand. My cost for my apartment was $200 a month and my food was $10 a day. So I was like averaging about like, what is that? Like $500 to $700 a month in my expenses. So that was really, really good. That was actually around the same time that we scaled like crazy. You know, around this time when it scaled like crazy, I was literally living like a monk, right? But I saved so much money. But the only way that you gotta do that is, like I said, you wanna start measuring how much you're actually spending. How much are you spending on a daily basis? Literally start spending money in cash so you can be well aware of what you're actually spending money on, right? Stop using a credit card, because when you're just swiping, you don't know exactly how much you're spending, right? Be very, very wary of how much money you're actually spending and measure that like crazy and make it a game. See how low you could actually make it. Which leads me to the third step, and that's understanding that if you really want to, for example, make wealth, all wealth is the difference between how much you make and how little you spend and investing the difference. That's really all wealth is, right? Like every single time you save, like for example, your expenses are $2,000 a month. Every time you save $2,000, you're like buying a month of your life back where you don't necessarily have to get like a job, right? And the more you save, that's just you buying more and more of your time. Like, can you buy like a year's worth of time if you have like 24 grand or $24,000 saved up? How about 2 years' time, 40 grand, right? So all retirement is just building up enough wealth where then you could invest it and get like a 10% return on your money every single year and take out 4% and live off of that in perpetuity, right? But it's not until I understood that concept of all wealth is decreasing my costs, increase my earning power, and then and investing and saving the difference, right? Which leads me to the fourth step in building my wealth, and that is find a way to increase my earning potential. So we literally have 77 free ways in the cheat sheet guide in the links below on all the ways that we've used to, for example, build wealth. But any one of these businesses would go ahead and do. Like, one of the easiest ways you can literally do what I did back in the time to build my initial wealth, as simple and stupid easy as it sound, was, I remember in my spare time, I would literally go to Walmart and copy and paste pictures on eBay, right? And when I would literally get a sale, like, look at this, $268, 12 have been sold. I would literally take that money and the customer shipping details and I would just buy it at Walmart as if I was the customer themselves. And when it says the shipping address, instead of putting my own shipping address, I just use the customer shipping address. And like that, I started making an extra $100 a day, guys. Guys, if all this did was get you to even make an extra $50 a day on the spare time, because this literally only took me like 30 minutes to an hour a day to go ahead and manage, would it actually be worth at least trying, right? And there's so many people, go ahead and do this. If you want to know exactly how to do that, just literally go ahead and go download the free 77 cheat sheet guide below and click on this right here. It's going to be the complete guide, right? Which leads me to the fifth step, and that is find a way to even crazier decrease your cost of living. So this is literally what I'm currently doing right now, because even though I know income's good, I know that if I go back home to the States, I know I'm gonna like keeping up with the Joneses is such a powerful thing that I don't wanna like fall prey to. So I literally went to a place like Nomadlist and I was like, okay, well, where else can I go that I could have similar values to people where they also want to make a bunch of money but save as much money as possible? And here are all these people where these expats and digital nomads make a bunch of money and they live. And one of the first places, like I said, I ended up moving to, where like my sister's at like right now, is literally Chiang Mai. because you could see that the cost of living is only $979. While I was there, my cost of living was actually $500 to $700 a month. And I was like, wow, not only can I live in this place where, for example, I spend a lot less, but I can also make a bunch of money, right? Which leads me to the fifth step, and that's start surrounding yourself around people that have similar values as you. That's why, for example, I started even interviewing them on my podcast because I was like, wow, you guys know so much stuff that I don't know and I can learn from you. And it just felt so good that I was surrounded by people that were making a bunch of money, but they weren't falling to prey to spending a lot of money. Like, for example, here, we all just have mopeds and scooters. I wear the same clothes every single day. And you know, no one really cares about how expensive your thing is, right? Like, everyone's more excited about like how little we spend. Like, when my friends find out that I literally live by the beach and I only spend like $700 a month, they're like, what? You only spend $700 a month on your place? I'm like, yeah. And it's just because I choose to live just a little bit further from like the city center. But you know, if you here in Asia, there's a huge beach line and like everywhere's the beach, right? So it's like a lot more affordable than you think to live by the beach. Does that make sense? Now, the sixth step that you need to do is understanding how to allocate your finances. And one way that I ended up doing that is this book right here. So as you can see, like I said, we've done multiple different businesses on the 77 cheat sheet guide below, where we've made like a considerable amount of money in like many of them, right? But one of the things that I was not well aware of is how to actually manage my finances once I make money. Because what happens when people start making money is they just spend it like idiots, like what I did, right? But they don't understand that they have to save money for taxes and operations costs and for investing in the future. So I literally systematized it with this book. Essentially what it is every single, like it's to automate all of your finances, right? So all of my money goes into one account, but from that account, I literally automated it to like automatically send out money to different accounts twice a month. Right? So twice a month, literally a percentage of the money that comes in goes into a separate checking account, which is literally just for taxes. So when the tax bill comes, I'm already ready for it, right? The second thing automatically goes out is for like my future, you know, investments, right? Where I can literally just save and invest and never have to work ever again for the rest of my life. And of course, this is in financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. This is just what I'm doing. Another one goes into the operations cost so I could reinvest back in my business, because I know that while an investment like an index fund can return 10% a year, my business could like give a 200 or a 400% return. And even though it's more risky, I like it's my core competency. So I'm well aware of it. I'm good at it. So I know I should double down on my, you know, unfair advantages for myself, if that makes sense, right? But understanding how to automate it is like very, very important. And automating a little bit, so I literally then put it in my box and literally live off of it for very, very little. And as this goes down, you know, I start getting more and more stingy, which is really good because then I don't spend a lot of money, right? Which leads me to the seventh step in having a bulletproof plan for your long-term financial freedom goals. Like I said, this is financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor, but getting this book alone literally changed the game for me. It demystified wealth for me like crazy. And it's literally a simple plan to wealth. So all it is when you go ahead and focus on one of these ways to make money online and increase your earning potential, and you have more profit and you decrease your earning, you decrease your living expenses and you find a way to increase your earning potential, now you're saving a lot of money every single month. Well, there's only so much money you could put back into your business, right? So you're probably wondering, how can I get it to the point where I literally, even if I don't want to build a business, never have to work ever again for the rest of my life? And it's pretty simple, it's just math. Like for example, now, like I live off of $2,000 a month, right? So let's just do the math. $2,000 a month times 12. That's essentially $24,000 a year, right? If I literally divide that by 0.04, which is the safe withdrawal rate that this book talks about, where you literally never have to work ever again for the rest of your life, I essentially only need $600,000 after taxes invested into the index funds that they talk about, which is VTSAX, it's just Vanguard's index fund, right? Where I literally could get a point where I could get $24,000 a year passively for the rest of my life. I don't need millions, guys. And you can see why it's a lot more realistic than what most people think. And with an online business, you can see people doing crazy numbers. Like even some of the people that we've interviewed on my podcast, like some of our success stories. Like look at this. This girl is literally 47 and she makes 30 grand a month. This guy made 100 grand in 2 months as an immigrant. This guy is from Australia. His name is Greg and he earns about 30 grand a month as a 57-year-old, right? So you could see that Within 2 years, if they keep their expenses low and save up all of this and just follow the things in this book, they could literally be put in a position where they never have to work ever again for the rest of their life. And that's literally what I wish I knew earlier on to just simplify everything. Like I said, break it down as simple as start a business, save as much as you can, invest it into whatever this book literally talks about. Like I said, this isn't financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. This is literally what I'm just doing right now. But if you want the fastest and easiest way to earn money right now, what we've talked to people in Thailand, in Bali, and in Las Vegas, then make sure you sign up for this week and this week's free workshop below, where it's the fastest way where people are going from zero to $1,000 days, faster than anything else imaginable. As well as check out my podcast with all these really successful people that make a bunch of money in land that live here in Bali. Like this 11-year-old girl that turned on $30 million, and this guy that makes $1 million from profit. Check it out right here. I hope this helps. Love you guys. See you guys later. Woo!